tasting chocolate is like tasting wine. I think that's a great way to look at it. Hi, my name is Trina Texon. I established True Chocolate in 2017 as a way for me to document my chocolate journey. So there is such a thing as a certified chocolate taster. It's a course that you take, it's a certification. It's a 5-day course that you take by the International Institute of Chocolate and Cacao Tasting. You have 2 exams you have to take. In my case, I did 1 and 2 together. So I am a level 1 and 2 chocolate taster. I had another certification in April. So a cacao evaluator is like a chocolate tasting exam as well. But in this case, for coffee with beans, cacao is also a crop that is the taste is affected by the terroir or where it was grown. So for cacao, based on the region, so for example, in the Visayas, I noticed that the notes are somewhat earthy, nutty, a little bit more subtle. And then when I taste beans, for example, from let's say Davao, they tend to be a bit more fruity and bright with some citrus notes. So those are the things you notice. And if you kind of listen to the language that I'm using, it's similar to how you describe wine. And I think out of the 3 that I mentioned, coffee, cacao, and wine, aside from tasting it, I think a lot of it has to do with appreciating the process that it takes to make a good bottle of wine, to make a good cup of coffee, to make a good chocolate bar. A lot of it is appreciation for the process. That's something that we want to do, is to create appreciation for Philippine cacao. And that's something we want to teach people about, the process of making chocolate. And because the Philippines is an origin country, meaning we plant cacao in our country. So that means that we are very fortunate, because cacao doesn't grow everywhere in the world. It only grows in certain parts of the world, and the Philippines is one of them. And as an origin country, we need to know more about how to make chocolate from the beans that we produce or that we grow. There's more focus on the inherent flavor of the cacao bean versus commercial chocolates, for example, or industrial chocolates. The process of bean to bar or tree to bar craft chocolate making. Just to let everybody know, I eat all kinds of chocolate. Even if you're, people think I only eat like fine chocolate or fine flavored chocolate, bean to bar chocolate, I eat all kinds of chocolate, because when you taste chocolate, you need to know all the different flavors. So I eat commercial chocolates, I eat local chocolates, imported chocolates. They're also my reference points, actually. So for me to know good flavor, I need to know all the different chocolates that are available in the market. So I try to taste as much chocolate as I can, and as many kinds of chocolate as I can. It's just when you get to a certain level where you learn to appreciate different flavor profiles, you realize that maybe the commercial chocolates are not giving you the flavor profiles that you're looking for. So same thing as maybe a more affordable bottle of wine versus a more expensive bottle of wine, or maybe same with coffee. Broma cacao also means food of the gods, and I agree.
For this event, it's cacao and chocolate tasting event. For us as chocolatier, we have to be responsible as well, to make sure that, you know, our cacao industry, especially here in the Philippines, is sustainable. We wanted to make sure we support the farm, the Philippine farm, Philippine farmers. You know, we make sure that we support those people that grows cacao here in the Philippines, not just to enjoy and consume chocolate. We also wanted to showcase Philippine chocolate and different possibilities using cacao and chocolate, not just in dessert, but also in savory and other forms. So we actually wanted to highlight the process of cacao to chocolate. The first dish, we named it cultivation. It replicates the cultivation of the cacao. So you can see on the dish itself, there's sprouts of microgreens growing to symbolize the cultivation or planting of the cacao seeds. Toasted choux pastry with whipped avocado and white chocolate cream. There's grilled tofu with olive oil, smoked salmon, fresh apple, calamansi fluid gel, and then there's dill and then microgreens. Second course, which is our main course actually, we call it the harvest. This is inspired by the fresh flavors during harvest season. So we have pineapple, mango, carrot, and cauliflower. So it's very bright. And then we also have adlai rice, and we have a braised pork belly with tableya or jus. So we use the juice of the pork belly that we braise, and then we add tableya into it to add the chocolate flavor. Third course, our first dessert, we call it fermentation. So this is inspired by the fermentation process. That's where we develop the flavors of the chocolate. So the flavors will be banana, passion fruit, calamansi. So it's very fruity. We have nuts as well, toasted praline nuts. We have white chocolate, and then we have the cacao pulp gel on top. It's very fresh. Next would be the drying and roasting. So we have the dark chocolate sponge cake, tableya chocolate mousse. The look of the dessert is inspired by the cacao bean that is being dried. It replicates the roasting process of the cacao. And lastly, we have the tempering and molding process. So that's actually the last step of the chocolate process. So it's very important because it's the skills that we need in order for you to create chocolate sculpture. We will serve chocolate bonbons, and then we have the white chocolate with mango jelly inside in a form of cacao fruit. The look of the dish actually has like little white chocolate cacao flower just to symbolize the new bloom of cacao. We will also serve cacao husk iced tea made of cacao husk, something refreshing, not your usual tea.
Good or bad chocolate, it depends. It would depend on the person eating the chocolate. Like for me, I grew up eating imported chocolates as well. You know, all of us did, I think, you know, all of us wanted, and all the pasalubongs were imported chocolates from the US and Europe. There's no good or bad chocolate, depends on how you look at it. I feel like all chocolate is made for the purpose of enjoyment. Depends on how you look at it, but for me, all chocolate is good, and it depends on the person who's consuming it, but I consume all kinds of chocolate, so no discrimination on the chocolates.